So BAD Fluppy threw me a suggestion of it was something that he played on the SNAPMAP review queue that he felt that I needed to check out. And so, I do like receiving those recommendations, and so I'm going to go ahead and check this out here. This is called Project SERAPH. It's by Impaler. The map ID on that is U49WNB6U, currently sitting in the review queue with 8 plays, 5 upvotes. According to the user, we are to locate and secure data files from an infested UAC research facility. It's a cool story, bro. Let's take a look at your profile. Haha, shiny. Impaler has logged 3 hours and 30 minutes of SnapMap playtime and accumulated 21,000 SnapMap points. This looks to be the user's second map, so we're just falling short of that goal I like to have, where a person's played at least 2 hours per map created. But again, this has been recommended by BAD Fluppy, so like I said, we'll go ahead and give it a check out here. So without further ado, let's go ahead and take a look at Project Seraph. Fun with emotes. All right, this button is ornamental. Okay, I have the charge 'em up charge mod thing. Anything else in my weapon wheel I need to be aware of? I got the pistol. That's good. Operation Seraph: search for survivors. Oh, life system and clearly indicated. Pretty good. Okay, I like it. What's going on over here? Oh, I see the POAs are on my compass. Which is cool. Alright, that door is opening, even though I don't necessarily want to go that way yet. Okay. You know what? Why am I wasting a shot? Dorks! Alright. Okay. Here is. Just an ornamental door. Fair enough. Cute amount it is, but I am being told by the little glowy arrow to go this way. Fine. Whoa! Hey guys. Ew. Kind of a mess in here, guys. You realize that, right? Alright, so. Well, I'm gonna just go ahead and guess you are not a survivor? Okay. Mean, I'm sure, many people have lived long, fulfilling lives as a torso and one arm. Okay, log 16, story stuff. Okay, today marks our 16th, 17th. I've lost track of day holding up the boss's office. We've heard some screams earlier, might have came from the warehouse. We contacted Earth weeks ago. Help should have come for us by now. I'll try to get some rest for tomorrow. Mark Shaw. Oh, Mark, we hardly knew you. By which I mean I literally never knew you. I have no idea who Mark Shaw is. Maybe we met at that party? I don't know. Does UAC have holiday parties, I wonder? Probably not. They're way too culty. UAC is like Umbrella Corporation meets Scientology, I swear. Let's see. Oh, hey, little Doom guy. Seeker found. Okay, cool. Right, so I guess the arrow leads us in this direction now. Thank you, helpful arrow. You are like Navi, only you don't talk. Right. Okay. What we gotta do the very second we get into this room here. Okay, nope. Most rooms, I don't make the automatic assumption that a secret is hidden in a specific place. This is one of, like, I want to say two or three rooms where, like, every single time I find myself in that room, I'm just immediately drawn to see if there's a secret in that one area. Alright, dude. Here, let me give you a hand. I totally invented that joke. Like, some may say that the 80s. One-liner, but no, I went back in time. But nope, okay, I can't activate this. Hey guys, you hear the hand joke I told earlier? It's pretty funny. Totally original too. Hey, have a nice trip. See, I'm full of unique, hilarious things that never once appeared in an 80s action movie. All right, tumor boomered. Okay, dudes. You know, I didn't even check to see if I had grenades when I did that, so I'm just so used to hitting the grenade button in that situation that now it's like the far too common way for me to find out that I don't have grenades is to like try doing that and then realize the button didn't do anything, or like end up throwing an ammo pack at somebody. Because like every once in a while somebody like gives me like the health or ammo dispenser rather than like a weapon in that area. Alright. Oop. Do-si-do action there. Oh, you didn't need that leg, did you? I got distracted by something glowing. It's me getting distracted by shiny things. And there was nothing there, of course. Alright. Still hearing the excited stuff's going on music there. Okay. I swear to God, another piggy. Hey, piggy. Okay. Oh. Alright, that thump could only mean Mr. Hell Knight has decided to join the party. Okay. Alright. No more lockdown, and a nice friendly POI to make sure that I don't get too lost. Hello, friendly POI. I'm gonna call you Gerald. What? So. Okay. Okay, so what am I supposed to do about this? Okay, no. Is there an alternate way to go that I'm not seeing immediately? Here is the next core nest. Ah, there we go. Alright. Cleared the battlefield. Let's go ahead and do the tumor thing again. So I'm liking the use of objectives and POIs to kind of keep the player from getting too lost in all of this. It's always important to note that sometimes you're gonna have players, and this is gonna become less frequent as, you know, time moves on and SNAPMAP becomes sort of a thing that only the people who are really into it will continue playing, but, generally speaking, there's always going to be a chance that somebody playing your map is like sort of a casual or a newer player and isn't quite as familiar with all of the modules. And you know, the thing is, I've spent a lot of time digging my way through all these modules, and I still get lost in them periodically. And owing to, like I said, I'm not the smartest guy in the world, there are certain modules I never use and. A lot of people don't ever seem to use. I just, like, every time I encounter them, I just kind of go, okay, so what's the way to get through this one again? In any case, in those situations, it's always awesome. Somebody, like, remembers to throw you a bone at the POI to kind of let you know what direction you're supposed to be going and stuff. Give you a little guidance. Yeah. Ooh. There we go. Alright. So that's second core nest destroyed. And we are ready to move on. Now, I feel like I got a little taste of this story going earlier. So it's kind of, there are some kind of story elements going on, but I feel like I'm craving a little more of that. Just something to sort of support what's going on here. Oh, hey! Or a chainsaw. That's a great way to keep my interest. A chainsaw. Alright. Adjust my butt. And number three is in this direction. More supplies, more gobbledygook on the walls. Switch to this real quick here, because one thing I've noticed with these encounters is it tends to be like there's always a couple of dudes defending the boomer tumor, and they're usually peanuts of some sort, so best to use your pistol to get rid of them so as not to waste your good ammo. Okay. Okay. All right. Okay, what did that do? Oh, I see more dudes down here, and again. Oh, okay. All right, it's time to have some fun with pistols. Why not? How about because I'm 42% health? Now is not a good time to get rooting here. I'd be a little more aware of where my health situation's at right now. A little better. And this room seems to have less of the my US recommended daily allowance of health pickups. There, where I got a little help from the Hell Knight. It's always nice when we can come together and work as a team to make sure Imps know who's in charge. Bring it! Sir Shotham is waiting. The stupid nickname my shotgun has now for some reason. Woof. Okay. Finally, get to crack open that live system. Somehow it spawned me over here on the other side of the dudes. So, whatever. Okay. And again, I really doubt I would have even died if I'd have, like, just a little more thought into using something other than the shotgun, but I'm here for fun, man. Fun is king. King Fun of Funland. King Fun has decreed that Zilla likes some shotguns. Alright, so that was all three of the Gornets. Alright, I'm already well over par- par time, apparently. Thanks for letting me know, board. So I think this is kind of a long backtrack. I'm gonna be honest here. I feel like a quicker route back to here would have been nice. Alright, I recognize this as a dead end room. Created survival wave and not the bog standard one, because if it is the bog standard one, there's a high probability there's going to be a period of time when it's just Lost Soul City in here. Here is, ooh, a hell night. Hey, maybe we did avert the whole Lost Soul thing entirely. That would be great if that happened, actually. I hate Lost Souls. Stuff over here that might be useful? No, only if I'm switching to my assault rifle, which I might not. Here. Alright, 30 seconds to go. Okay, and we're going to be starting to deal with bigger, badder, big bads here. That's what happens when you get yourself trapped in a corner. The heck am I doing way out here? This seems weird. Why am I way out here? Well. Don't think that's exactly how the board was supposed to work. Fortunately, it's a manual lockdown, so the enemies still know to get through the door to come get me. So I can probably still finish the board. Alright, so I downloaded the files. Great. Oh, well, apparently I can come in here. Alright. Fine. Good. Alright, I removed the USB drive. Leave the facility. Alright. What are the chances this is the last thing I'm going to have to deal with, I wonder? I'd say my odds are super good. Swell, even. I think these guys are my welcoming committee. They're here to congratulate me on a job well done. And, wait, why am I wasting my time? I have a chainsaw. Another one. Come on. Why? Why not just have them both come out at the same time? Third time's a charm, I guess. Four, maybe? Oh my god! Why? Why? I don't understand. Why am I fighting a fourth idiot? Alright, let's see if I can actually score around it. Secret you are. Man. Hope it gives me something real good, like 1,000 health and a picture of Dude Guy's mom or something. That would be... There we go. Nope, it's just a secret. Whatever. Oh, jeez. Well, I got it. Part. Now let's see if I can escape the facility with all my Ghiblis intact here. Never mind. Too stupid. Oh, crap. Oh, wait. I think I have a strategy. Come on. You come down here and say that, you bozo. No. Alright, come on. No, I can't get through there. Doggone it. So in the abstract, this was a fun board. I really enjoyed myself playing it for the most part. And, you know, I like that the goals are very simple and straightforward. I like that the player was being led in a very effective, clear way with the point of interest markers and the mission objectives. Great use of those elements there, you know. I like that there were a few surprises. I mean, it did not stick to expectations the way you figured it would. There were a couple things in there I felt were like questionable decisions as far as design was concerned. The first was there was what I would consider an unfun amount of backtracking. The three gore nests being spread out the way they were creates this situation where you, by the time you get the third gore nest, you end up having to walk your way back from a very far point to a point near the very beginning. Now, you know, there's I've I'm I've put long walks into my own maps, usually. What I like to do, though, is I like to reverse it. What I like to do is I make the long walk, the long empty walk, the first thing they do, so that they have a lay of the land for when they have to fight their way back. And what that does is, at least with the, when they're heading out in that direction, they have, like, all of this, you know, they can look around, they can explore things, they can figure out what's where, they can look for secrets, things like that. What happens is, though, when you've already fought your way through an area, and you have to work your way back, there's a little bit less of that, because a lot of folks are just really good at sort of looking for the secrets and exploring the room and grabbing everything that the room has to offer while they're in the middle of a firefight, or even like immediately after they have their firefight. But when they're walking their way back from way out in East Jahunga, where they complete the final objective to get to a door in the beginning, there's not as much to do. It's not quite as captivating. And so there weren't a lot of sort of little extra... There would have been some great opportunities for maybe some little extra ganks to come in or some extra things to happen that I think could have alleviated that. Or, you know, the other option, just, you know, put a quick travel teleport thing in there that'll get you back there a little quicker. The second one was I'm not sure what was going on with the Baron of Hell fight that repeated itself. Now, you know, there's a whole idea behind a concept of a rule of threes. So, like, obviously, when I fought two of them, I was like, okay, well, I'll fight a third one. When the fourth one popped up, and it's like, I don't have the resources to deal with a fourth Baron of Hell, and, like, I've already picked up all the pickups throughout most of the map. You know, what am I supposed to do here? It did create kind of a situation where I wouldn't say it was ganky, but it was definitely like, okay, why did this happen? In any case, I mean, you know, those are sort of just little nagging things that I feel like I have to bring up as sort of, you know, obviously, when you want to give good feedback, you have to be honest about everything good and bad. And so, you know, generally speaking, I had a lot of fun with this map. I think the life system was fair. I believe the combat was balanced throughout for the most part. And with, you know, the backtracking and the weird Baron of Hell thing at the end aside, you know, everything about it was just well constructed and well thought out. So kudos to that. Once again, that's Project Seraph by Impaler. That's map ID U49WNB. B6U, currently in the review queue and looking to earn its stars, so help it out with an upvote if you can. Game on, game on, game on, game on.